thanks for joining me. Tenacious Tina here. I've got my little bear friend. Isn't he cute? Say hello. Hey. I'm a special kind of bear friend. Well, I wanted to tell you a story that is so true and verified by my sister, and I did converse with her today on the phone to make sure the details of this was along the same path as hers, because it was a long time ago and it has been scientifically proven that long-term memories, we think sometimes, you know, we think, oh, I remember that very well, but it's been scientifically proven that we only remember 50% of those memories, even though we might think we got it, picture in our head, word for word. But so I did want to make sure I was speaking truth on this, and we are on the same line with this, so I feel confident that I'm giving correct information. So I'm gonna let Mr. Bear sit right here while I tell the story. It was in the late 80s. I was 16. She was about 18. I guess it would have been 1986, probably. We were in Cobb County on Austell Road over there, going into Zayers, which is now Target, but back then it was Zayers. They got bought out or merged or something. I knew that my sister had just cast her check, because back then, when you were that age, we didn't have debit cards and we were too young to have a credit card. So not everybody wanted to take a check from you. You would have a hard time as a youngster, you know, cashing a check somewhere or writing a check, even, you know. So it was just easier to have that cash. And as we got almost to the front of the store, we were out still on the sidewalk. There was a man, I guess his very early 20s. He was walking very intently towards us, very fast paced, as if he wanted to walk right through us and bust us up. And I thought, well, what a jerk, you know. And I think I may have even said to her, look at this guy, what's he doing? But she kind of just, I don't know, she was in the middle of talking and not studying on him, and probably assumed he was going to walk around us, but he just wasn't. And it happened so fast that I saw him coming, because, you know, I was watching him, and her handbag was the kind you put under your arm and didn't have any straps on it, so she was probably an easier target for him to approach. I had a shoulder bag over the shoulder bag, so I kind of locked down on mine because of it, seeing him come at us like that, and he did not get mine, but unfortunately he did hers, and he took off running like Forrest Gump, and I knew we couldn't catch him at all, so I started yelling. But it was his day off, and he was packing. He had his gun on him, but he was in his street clothes, and so he comes to rescue these damsels in distress, and he pulls out his gun. Stop! Freeze or I'll shoot! And the guy turns around and pulls out a gun in retaliation. He had a gun too. Who knew? I didn't know he had a gun. So he takes off up this fence, starts climbing this fence, and the guy gives him a warning. And I don't know if he dropped it intentionally or accidentally, but he dropped her handbag, thank the Lord. And he got over the fence and took off, but we got the purse back. Of course, they took us in Target, and we filled out police reports and paperwork, and they tried to catch him. They stayed in contact with us for a few weeks after that over the phone, but you know, we cared, but we didn't care. We were just so glad that we got that money back. And he was, they suspected, in connection with a lot of other muggings and robberies in the area. So they probably caught up to him eventually, I figured. Now, did I handle that the right way? I don't know. Yeah, I got the money back. You know, when you're that age, you think you're just invincible and you're bulletproof. I mean, of course, I didn't even know I had a gun when I did all of that. But would I do it again? I don't know. I guess you really don't know what you're going to do, how you're going to act until you get in that situation. And then you just sort of, I guess, view and judge the situation for what's going on at that time. Now, if he had pulled the gun out initially in the very beginnings, no, I probably would not have hoot and hollered and carried on like that. But I didn't think he had a weapon, so I felt more secure, you know, in doing all of that. So, I don't know. If anything like that's happened to you, leave a comment. Or if you want to share your story or leave your opinion on that, if you have one, that is something we'll never forget. And, you know, just every time we go anywhere, we hold on to our purses now like they were gold and look around. And I know she's still nervous to this day. People can scare her easily if she's approached off guard. And I guess she's got a little PTSD from that event. And me, I'm not like that, but I mean, I have PTSD but from other stuff in my life. But I do hold on to my purse everywhere I go. Thanks for watching.